Tension on the Korean Peninsula pushed to the brink of war. That's the word from state media in North Korea on Friday, a reference to the US naval fleet powering towards the region as fears mount of a rocket launch or even a nuclear test from Pyongyang, which is gearing up for Saturday's Day of the Sun celebration, the 105th anniversary of the birth of state founder Kim Il-sung. Donald Trump has put North Korea on notice, saying he won't tolerate any provocation from Pyongyang and that he believes Chinese President Xi Jinping will be key in, quote, fixing the problem.
I think he's going to try very hard.
For its part, China is pushing a message of diplomacy to ease the situation. Japan, though, has confirmed that its National Security Council has held talks on how to evacuate nearly 60,000 Japanese citizens from South Korea in the event of a crisis.
All right, this is Matthew chapter, Matthew chapter 24, verse 6. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Barakatah Yahweh. Barakatah Yahweh Shai.
Barakatah Yahweh Shai.
Barakatah Yahweh.
Barakatah Yahweh.
Barakatah Yahweh Shai.
Barakatah Yahweh Shai.
Barakatah Yahweh.
Barakatah Yahweh.
Barakatah Yahweh Shai.
Barakatah Yahweh Shai.
First and foremost, we want to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh,
Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai.
Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Yashirallah, who are better known as Great Millstone, they rule very well. Salutations to the elect and unto sincere brothers, you sincere disciples in Great Millstone and under the Great Millstone banner that's continuing to preach, prophesy, push, and endure all in the name of Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
I'm the brother, Anwar Manassadok.
Ashiar Rakar.
All right. And as you just seen, man, that video basically saying that, things can kick off between China and so like between the U.S. and North Korea, all right. But according to the scriptures, we know that what we just read here in Matthew is what Yahweh Shai prophesied, that there will be wars and rumors of wars. Okay, so this is another rumor of war, you know, of a war. You know, mm-hmm. We know that according to the scriptures, the war. Okay, all worlds lead to the Middle East. Okay, the Valley of Jehoshaphat. Israel, okay. If you notice the in the media, who they're not really talking about is Israel. You know, Israeli, should I say? You know,
and that's that magic, man.
Yeah, exactly.
They keep you distracted with one thing while behind the closed doors or behind right in your face, a sleight of hand. They're doing some whole total opposite shit, man.
Yep.
And like the brother said, man, they're not talking about Israel.
Yep. Yeah, hey, I was gonna say them rats, man. They control the media, man. You know, they control all the news outlets, even RT. You know, even though RT pushes a little bit more than CNN, but they control all these news outlet or media sources. You know, so they're working in the shadows. They're guiding Donald Trump's hand, basically. You know, and we know it's ultimately the Most High that's controlling all these things, but they're telling Donald Trump what to do. You know. That's why he attacked Syria like that. But yeah, you got this another theater of war opening up over here in the Asia Pacific between the U.S. and North Korea. And whether something goes down or not, you know, this is not what's going to spark off the third war, you know?
No, it's not. It's not. And it's, you know, the funny shit is that, you know, all these countries are against each other, but then yet they come together on different aspects.
Right.
Like you got America and China united on one accord against North Korea, mm-hmm. but yet on another front, America and China are at ends.
Yep.
Man.
Yeah, you know, exactly.
In the South China, it was a South China Sea.
South China Sea. Yep.
Yeah,
they were just
they're talking about it's war if America comes past a certain line, or it's the declaration of war.
Yep.
You know, but then yet on this right here front, they're collaborating.
It's all a game, man. It's all a joke. You know, it's all a joke. You know, because you know when they, after Donald Trump and China, you know, or Xi Jinping went down to Florida and they talked, you know that when Xi Jinping left, Donald Trump was talking shit about him and then vice versa, mm-hmm. you know? So yeah, man, it's all a game. They all backstab each other. But that's why the Most High is bringing them all down into the Valley of Jehoshaphat. You know, I'll get that too.
And I was going to say this, and that's exactly why they call it the theater of war, man.
Exactly.
Because on a theater, what do you have? You have actors.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're just playing roles, man. This ain't nothing sincere from them individuals. They got strings in their back, man.
Yep.
You know, there's somebody behind the scenes pulling those strings, man. giving them lines to speak, you know. And most of those writers that be writing their little shits be the Jews, man, them rats.
Yep, yep. The same ones that write the movie scripts, man, and yep. the sitcom scripts, mm-hmm. you know. Mm-hmm. So it's all a game to these Edomites, man. But once Yahweh Shai cracked them clouds, they gonna find out that this is real life, man. All right,
it's real business, man.
Yep, that these prophecies are real, you know. All right, this is Joel chapter 3, verse 9. Proclaim ye this among the Gentiles. Prepare war. Wake up the mighty men. Let all the men of war draw near. Let them come up. Beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong. So like it's spears. I think I said spears. Let the weak say, I'm strong. Assemble yourselves and come, all ye heathen. Okay, so that's what you see, man. All these heathen are assembling themselves to go to war down there in the Middle East, man. All yeah. right? Now, granted, yeah, you're going to have other theaters of war just like it was in World War I and World War II, you know, when you go back and do the research. But the main focus is going to be on the middle of the globe, okay, the middle of the world, which is the Middle East, okay, yeah. mainly Israel. You know, it says, and gather yourselves together round about, did the cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Lord, all right? Just like the apostle said, the angels are going to be refereeing these. Well, the angels are refereeing this thing already, man. Okay, because the Most High is sending them angels down to get into the ears of these leaders and tell them what to do. All right,
yeah, going to the word that we went into last week at camp, the Middle East is going to be the epicenter of this World
yeah,
War III.
That's man. Right. Yeah,
that's going to be the main point where all is going to originate from, man. Mm-hmm. It's where everything's about to pop off at in the Middle East.
That's right. Yep, that's right. And hey, Donald Trump didn't drop that bomb or those couple bombs. The Moab. Mother of all bombs.
Yeah, and, the biggest non-nuclear bomb.
Yeah. And then it was funny, Russia dropped the father of all bombs, you know, the FOAB. So, hey, it's a lot of chess beating right now, man.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, it is. King Kong. Yeah. Fuck you niggas.
But, yeah, Donald Trump didn't shoot 59 missiles because Donald Trump wanted to do that. Hey, Donald Trump did that because the Lord wanted Donald Trump to do that, you know. So, hey, these rats, they think they're orchestrating everything, but the Most High, he has his angels at work, man. Okay, mm-hmm. doing all this stuff.
They think they're the puppet masters, but they on strings too. Exactly. They on the Most High strings, man.
Yep.
You know, he said he created the wicked to do wickedly.
That's right.
So, yeah, you motherfuckers, you guys have a script that you guys is playing that the Most High read for you.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep, it's just like chess, except the Most High is playing both sides. All right? It says verse 12. Let the heathen be wakened and come up to the valley of Jehoshaphat, which is the whole area of the Middle East, man. Okay, and Jehoshaphat means Yahweh Shaphat in the Hebrew. When you translate it, okay, it means
the Most High's judgment.
Yep, the Most High's judgment. Yep, it says for there will I sit to judge all the heathen round about. Okay, and that's what's coming.
That judgment is going to be destruction, man. Based off of the way you've been carrying yourself and the way you've been living, man. You're being judged for how you was conducting yourself on earth, man, mm-hmm. which was in wickedness. So ultimately, you need to be destroyed, man. And that's why you're going to be in that valley, man.
Yep.
To be destroyed.
That's right. Hey, get this, man. I just seen this. It says democracy dies in darkness. And that's right, man. Hey, when the missiles get shot to and fro, I believe the apostle was just going in on this, man. In a sit down this week. Saying that it's gonna be thick darkness, you know, throughout when the missiles are shot here in America, mm-hmm. you know, it's gonna be thick darkness. So that's right, man. Democracy, America. Basically, you can replace that with America, cause they harp on democracy. America dies in darkness, man. You know.
And is that not the power of the elite? Is to be in secrecy.
Yeah. Yep.
And how do you stay in secrecy? Moving in the shadows, man.
Mm-hmm.
And then the scriptures tell you, woe to him that seek deep to hide their counsel.
From the Most High.
Yeah, yeah, and that's exactly what these motherfucking Edomites and all these other nations think that they're doing, man. Think that they're secretly keeping the elect of the Most High down. But yet and still, all you're doing is purifying us, man, and making us to be that choice metal to Yahweh Bosh and Yahweh Shai, man.
That's right. Yep. Making us stronger. Mm-hmm. You know, Lord willing, we be those men, man. You know? And that's what endure means, you know, to make hard, you know. It says, North Korea says the U.S. is escalating the situation, which is absolutely true, man. Okay, when I was over there in South Korea, man, that's all them sergeants and generals would say, man, that we was basically provoking North Korea, man.
Yeah.
when we shoot, it was towards North Korea, you know, towards the 38th parallel, so to speak. Missiles, the tanks, when they're shooting, when we're shooting our rifles, it's all towards North Korea, you know, and they see that, man. North Korea sees that, and it's the U.S. is doing all that to provoke them because they want to go into North Korea. Man, they'll be North Korea to a pulp, man.
Yeah.
You know, in a matter of hours, man. You know.
It's all about positioning, though, man. They yep. want to get into North Korea because North Korea is what? Who they border? They border China.
Yep. And
so
Russia.
Yeah, exactly. So boom, they get North Korea. That's a strategic place to be, man. Because then you're right there, man. Shit yep. pop off, then you can fuck with both of those nations, man. And that's yeah. exactly why China don't want America in there, man. Same, Russia don't want America in there neither.
Yep. Yeah, I'm glad you said that, brother, because this goes, see, North Korea is like close to China and Russia, you know. So it's a very strategic spot, and then it's a lot of resources America want to get to down there. So like, yeah, I want to try to get a bigger map, you know.
See, because you probably zoom into it.
Yeah, actually, let me try this. But yeah, I'm glad you said that because the North Korea or the Korean War, the Korean War that took place back in 1950 to 1953 was actually a proxy war between Russia and America. You know, Russia and the United States. And China was involved in it also. So the major players you see that's participating in this theater of war right now is the same players that was back after World War II, you know, that was actually going against each other. So yeah, you see how North Korea's it borders right here with China. And then you have Russia right here, you know. Russia's right here. You see how the language changes right here to Russia or Russian. And then it's Chinese right here. And then you got the North Korea right here, you know. So these three are allies, man, okay? North Korea, China, and Russia, they're allies. So, yeah, China can say, okay, America, yeah, we'll listen to you and try to calm North Korea down, try not to, or tell them not to shoot off a missile. But behind closed doors, behind the scenes, they can say North Korea, yeah, shoot off that missile. We want to provoke the U.S. so they can come in here so, you know, this war can get cracked off. Because all these nations hate America, man, you know. But, hey, that was a proxy war. The 1950 Korean War was a proxy war. And now you're seeing that it's all leading up to where these proxy wars are going out the window. These big superpowers are being forced to meet head-to-head and clash, man. You know?
Hey, I give you an analogy from the world, man. It's just like, say you're from a hood, you got a bunch of your little homies fighting and doing all the, you know,
right.
banging and all the shit.
Yeah.
Eventually, it gets up to the OGs where now it's all out war. It's like, yeah. no, fuck. The little homies got to step aside now. Yeah. Not an OG about to come bang. Yep. It's really about to go down. So yeah. That's exactly what it's coming down to, man. It's the head honchos, you know, the heads. They coming down and it's real life business, man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's right. Yep. It says North Korea says the U.S. is escalating the situation on the Korean Peninsula, but let CNN tell it Korea is escalating. North Korea is escalating. Yeah. As Pyongyang prepares for a celebration, so they're preparing to celebrate. So why would they be escalating the situation to go to war? You know, it makes no sense. But you see how they this is all conditioning and this is all propaganda, you know. This is all propaganda to demonize North Korea, which, you know, forget them gooks, you know. But you see the games that the U.S. likes to play, okay. And I have to highlight a show on Netflix, Oliver Stone's The History, The Untold History of the United States. That's a good show for brothers to watch, man, you know. It shows the backdoor deals, the demonic BS that Esau does behind closed doors here in America to all these other nations. And that's why these nations hate America, you know. It's just that they're not as strong to take on America, or they wasn't as strong to take on America. But the Most High is putting that fighting spirit in them, you know, to get ready to come up against America, man.
Come on. All right.
It says, I mean, if you wanna, you know, you wanna read or whatever, you got
no,
something
no,
to say.
Not, you got it, bro.
Okay. It says, this is the sun.com. Okay, and we'll post these links in the description box below, but we're just, you know, hitting key points. It says, World War III fears. Kim Jong-un, his name is really Un Jung Kim, but it says, declares he's on the brink of a war with the U.S. as Donald Trump is urged to assassinate North Korean despot. All right, and these devils, this devil Donald Trump, man, he don't care, man. All right, he's not behind closed doors saying, yeah, I want to assassinate North Korean, the North Korean president. He's saying it on live national TV, man. All right. Now that was unheard of in the past presidencies, man. They would do their stuff in secrecy, man.
Exactly.
So now Donald Trump, he's just he got the cojones to come out and just say, yeah, I want to assassinate the president. Forget that, you know. So hey, if this place was to go on, they would in the long run, they would get the United States on war crimes and stuff, you know, because that was a so-called war crime they did, shooting off 59 missiles.
And China's with it though. China wants to change the regime too.
Yep.
You know, but then at the same time, China doesn't, because then if America gets in there, then what is it?
Yeah, exactly. That's right now. China, North Korea is a buffer zone for China, you know, to keep America out, you know. But it's just like that game of Risk, you know. Playing that game of Risk, you want to keep that superpower from getting into a certain position, because if they get into that position,
it's
detrimental
over.
For you.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly. It's detrimental for the world.
Yeah, kind. It says, North Korea warned it is ready to deliver the most ruthless blow. Right, it's the weak saying I'm strong here in Joel, you know.
And the brother Ariala always states that North Korea doesn't even have missile guidance systems. So who the fuck are you guys huffing and puffing with, man? You guys, you got the nuclear capability, but you don't have the brains to map that shit so it can get to where it needs to
go. Right.
So man, stop all that huffing and puffing, man.
Yeah, it's like for the wrestling, you know, you used to watch wrestling. It's like the Undertaker trying to fight a midget or something, you know. Mm-hmm. Rey Mysterio. Undertaker trying to fight Rey Mysterio, you know.
Mm.
It's like that, man. So that's what they're saying, man. America is just going around the world bullying everybody, you know, telling people, well, you can't do this, you can't do that. But then on the back end, they're doing it, you know. They're getting nuclear missiles, but telling people they can't get nuclear missiles. It's all hypocritical, you know. But this is Joel 3:10. Beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say I'm strong, okay? And that's what North Korea's saying, you know. We're ready to deal the most ruthless blow. Which is all words, you know, but North Korea knows who's backing them. China and Russia, you know. It says, as a major U.S. naval exercise ramps up tensions in the region. Okay.
Yeah, because that's from what you seen the first little snippet we showed. You seen the warships, America's warships headed straight towards North Korea.
Yep.
And that's what this article is talking about.
Yep. Kim Jong-un has placed his country on the brink of war as a high-profile defector. All these countries are on the brink of war, man. They're on edge, man. Especially after what Donald Trump just did, shooting off the 59, yep, 59 missiles, without even going to Congress, man. So this guy, he's headstrong, man. You know, as a high-profile defector, urged U.S. President Donald Trump to assassinate the despot North Korean leader before he fires his nuclear weapons at America and the U.K. Hopefully, hey, this man, Donald Trump, orders them to shoot missiles and it kills Kim Jong-un and all his leadership and it sparks them off. But
yeah,
this
China's not about to let America just go in there and take over.
Right, right.
So even though they're hand in hand right now, as soon as that happens, China is going to be rushing to get in there before America does,
mm-hmm.
man.
Yep. Yeah. But yeah, I was saying this ain't going to be what the ultimate, you know, thing to kick off that World War III, third war.
We know why. We're going to get to that.
Exactly. Yeah. All right. So this is at dailymail.com. China deploys 150,000 troops to deal with possible North Korean refugees. Fears Trump may strike Kim Jong-un following a missile attack on Syria. All right. And this was dated April 10th. Okay. So 4 days ago. Trump's Syria strike Friday was widely interpreted as a warning to North Korea, China, And it was to Russia, Syria. It was to the world,
to basically. To the world, exactly.
Yeah. It says China, which was left shocked by the airstrikes, has deployed medical and backup units from the People's Liberation Army forces to the Yalu River. Okay, and there's games out there. Forget the name of the one game, but it shows America and China going head to head, man. Okay, so these devils, they know. All right, they know what's coming. You know, mm-hmm. It says the troops have been dispatched to prepare for preemptive attacks by the U.S. Oh, also I can, if I may say this too, the Air Force is stopping troops from airmen from leaving. They call it stop loss. So whatever their contract says for them to get out, and it's all over the military, you know, they call it stop loss. But mm-hmm. when your contract tells you to get out, they can say, no, you're going to stay in beyond your contract, but we'll pay you back that time. You know, so if they need you for a war, they can keep you beyond your contract, you know. Yeah. So them devils are slick, man.
You know? Yeah, they actually showed that movie in that movie Jarhead, the first one.
Yep. Yeah, so that's what's taking place now. That's how you know that the American military is about to go to war, okay? Because they're making these troops stay in beyond their contract, and they're going to send them out there to the Middle East, man.
You know? Have a draft, too.
Yep. And women are going to be drafted, okay? The troops have been dispatched to prepare for preemptive attacks by the U.S. The U.S. Navy has moved the USS Carl Vinson Aircraft Strike Group from Singapore to North Korea. That's why they're in all those Southeast Asian countries like that. They're surrounding China, you know. They're down in Malaysia and Philippines, which the Philippines want to kick them out, you know, Taiwan, so on and so forth, you know, Australia.
Yeah, they're trying to be as close to Korea as they can be. Yeah. So when the shit pop off, they can rush in there and try to stake their claim.
Yep.
But if China's right there at the border, China's going to be the first on ground.
Yeah.
And that's why China sent all those troops over there. Mm-hmm. So they can be the first into Korea if they kill off Kim Jong-un.
Yep.
Or Un Jong Kim.
And yeah, they're all down in here, Thailand and whatnot. You know, I think Bangkok is Thailand. You know, Vietnam War was, I was just watching that earlier. But the Vietnam War, that was another proxy war, man, you know. So you got all these different proxy wars that was taking place. But now that the big heads, the big wigs is about to go at it, you know. But yeah, this is the main goal for Esau here in America, you know, is China. You know, they want China. You know,
and Russia.
Yep.
Both of them shits.
It says, so that's the point on that. We're about to get to some scriptures. NBC News, Trump's options for North Korea include placing nukes in South Korea. Okay. Another provocation. They already sent the B-52s over there. Now they got the ships in place. Okay. So they're ready for war, man. Okay. On all these fronts. But like we keep saying, man, it's going to kick off in the Middle East, man. But this all goes back to the wars and rumors of wars. Let me grab this, too, since we keep saying that. You know, these rats, man, over there in Israeli, they're going to kick this war off, man.
Exactly.
This is Jeremiah 49:20. Therefore, hear the counsel of the Lord that he hath taken against Edom, and his purposes that he hath purposed against the inhabitants of Teman. Surely the least of the flock shall draw them out. Surely he shall make the habitations desolate with them.
Yes, and who's the least of the flock, man? It's some so-called Israelis, man. Because, hey, man, they're the least of Esau. But yet, at the same time, they're the head of Esau. And they're going to be ones to kick that shit off, man.
That's right.
And as the scripture said, the least of the flock shall draw them out. They're going to be one that kicked off World War III, man. Because they're going to go up against Iran. And then that's what and Iran and Russia... That's big brother, little brother right there.
Yep.
And then America in Israel, that's big brother, little brother right there. So either way it goes, man, it's going to pop off, you know? And Israel's going to be the ones to kick this shit off, as the scripture states. So all the shit that Kim Jong-un or Un Jong Kim's talking, man, yeah, you can keep talking all that fluff, man. You know, China sending their troops, all this, yes, it's all fine and dandy, but it tells you that Israel's gonna be the one to kick it off.
Yep. This is Revelation This the one I wanted, the 8 and 13. All right. It says, actually, it was the third one coming quickly, but I'll read this one if you want to break it down. Okay. This is Revelation 8 and 13. And I beheld and heard an angel flying through the midst of heaven, saying with a loud voice, woe, woe, woe to them.
And those three woes, each one of those represents a world war.
Yep. Go ahead. Yep. And World War One was 1914 and 1917. World War II was 1939 and 1945, and then you got World War III,
which hasn't come yet, but it's coming though.
Yeah, which really we in it, you know, to be honest. They just ain't declared it, you know. But yeah, that was like 72 years ago now, you know, was 1945. It says, woe, woe, woe to the inhabitants of the earth, Salakia, if I can say real quick.
What?
This third war is going to be a true world war, you know. This is going to be a true world war, like World War I and World War II. It wasn't all the countries, you know, but this is going to involve everybody, okay? This is going to involve everybody, and then it's going to bring about the return of Yahweh Shai, okay?
Exactly.
It says, to the inhabitants of the earth by reason of the other voices of the trumpet of the three angels which are yet to sound.
Exactly. Those trumpets haven't sounded yet, because when that last trump sound, man, that's when Yahweh Shai comes back, man.
That's right.
You know, cause we're towards the end of the sixth trumpet, and when that seventh trumpet sounds, man, hey man, it's time to get the fuck up out of here, man.
Yep.
As Revelation says, man, come up out of her,
that's right.
As you be not partakers of her sins, of her plagues. If we're roughly paraphrasing,
yep.
You know,
plagues, yep.
Of her plagues. Yeah. So when that last trump sounds, man, it's time to get the fuck up out of here.
That's right. Yep. Revelation 11 and 14. The second war is past, and behold, the third war coming quickly.
There's no reason to break that down. It's plain as day, man.
Yeah.
It cometh quickly, man. Because one day with Yahweh is as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years one day. That's why it's hastening quickly, man.
That's right.
Because on Yahweh's time, man, this shit is, it's only been a matter of seconds and minutes.
That's right.
You know?
Yep. Yeah, and all these nations, these heathen nations that's going to be down there in the Middle East, and 2/3, okay, which are counted as heathens. All right, 2 parts of Israel, okay. Well, I say the wicked of Israel, okay, because the 2/3 are gonna be killed here in America,
mm-hmm.
You know. But them wicked ass niggas down there that go down into the Middle East, that's in the military, they're gonna try to fight Yahweh Shai, man. Okay, they're gonna turn and try to fight Yahweh Shai, and they're gonna be beaten to powder, man. Okay,
to dust. And some of you niggas are gonna be getting eaten by that fucking, what's that shit called? That the machine that eats people. That they built to be out there in the wars and shit.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I forget though.
That its fuel is bio.
It's like the eater.
Bio something fuel. That's basically like human bodies and shit.
Yep.
It eating your dead bodies, your corpses is what fuels it to keep moving.
Kind. Yeah, I believe the apostles went in on that.
Yeah, they went on a couple years back.
Kind. Yeah. Did you want to get this, the Matthew,
and then we get this? Yeah, come.
Or you want to end with it?
We can end with the Matthew. Kind
of. All right. So this is you want to read?
Come. All right. Or you want to start one?
Verse one.
All right. This is 2 Ezra 16 verse 1. Woe be unto thee, Babylon and Asia. Woe be unto thee, Egypt and Syria.
So hey, that basically covers the whole world, man. Cause that's the Middle East. Then you got Asia, okay, which is what we're talking about right now with Kim Jong-un, China, America over there in the South Asia Pacific, okay, Egypt, okay, which is also in the Middle East. But then you can also say America, because America's modeled after, or not modeled after, but it's also known as the Egypt, you know, which is a word synonymous with bondage, and Syria, which where Donald Trump just shot 59 missiles into Syria, okay?
Yeah.
And I believe in Isaiah 17, it talks about Damascus being a ruinous heap, man. Okay? So that's in game when you start seeing either America or Israeli attacking Damascus and utterly destroying it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Verse 2. Gird up yourselves with clothes of sack and hair. Bewail your children and be sorry, for your destruction is at hand. And a sword is sent upon you. And who may turn it back?
Yep, that sword is the ICBMs, okay? The intercontinental ballistic missiles, okay? And it says, who may turn him back? Nobody, because this is all it was all prophesied and spoken into existence by Yahweh by Shema Shai.
Right.
Okay. So these weapons they got, they're making now, okay, they're beating their plowshares and the swords and the pruning hooks and the spears. Okay, it was they're not doing that to party or to shoot all the nukes up in the air to collide in mid air and
giggles.
So, yeah, you know, or filling it with confetti, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
This is real, man. Okay, and it's gonna be a lot of bloodshed. All right.
There is a motive behind that, man.
Yep. Yep.
Verse 4: A fire is sent among you, and who may quench it? Mm-hmm. Plagues are sent upon you.
It's a lot. Yeah. Isaiah 47 is a good precept for that. You know, just throwing it out there. You know.
Come. Verse 5: Plagues are sent unto you, and what is he that may drive them away? May any man drive any in hunger hungry
away, drive away.
Oh, so I can. Verse 6: May any man drive away an hungry lion in the wood, or may any one quench the fire in stubble when it hath begun to burn? May one turn again the arrow that is shot of a strong archer?
And guess who that strong archer is, man? It's the Lord, man. Yahweh Shema Shai. Okay, and guess what? Those missiles are the army of Yahweh Shema Shai. It speaks about that in Joel chapter 2. You know,
so is it that fire in the stubble? Yeah. Who is a consuming fire?
The Lord, yeah.
Exactly. So once he starts burning this shit, it's a wrap.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Yeah,
verse 8, the mighty Lord sendeth the plagues, and who is he that can drive them away?
That's right. Yeah, you got the Elisha that's trying to upset prophecy, man.
Yeah.
Who are you, all right?
Who?
You about to find out. You ain't squat. I put it that way.
Does it not say in Job 14 that he is determined that the time, I mean, he gave you he's determined.
He set a balance that he cannot surpass.
Yeah, yeah, you know? Kind of roughly paraphrasing, man. Yeah. That, hey, man, you guys have a balance you can't pass. So all this, as hard as you're going, you're going to hit a brick wall.
Yep.
Eventually, you're about to hit a brick wall, and it's just screeching all. No more. You can't go. Can't pass go no more.
Yeah.
It's a wrap.
Yeah.
Okay?
Trump's trying to.
He's trying to. They're trying to upset prophecy, but you can't, man.
Yeah.
Your arms ain't long enough to box with Yahweh, man.
That's right.
Neither his son, Yahweh Shai. Okay?
Yep.
Verse 9. A fire shall go forth from his wrath, and who is he that may quench it?
That's right.
He shall cast lightnings, and who shall not fear? He shall thunder, and who shall not be afraid?
And that's what's going to happen when you read 2 Exodus 13. When Yahweh Shai returns, that's what's going to happen, man. Okay? But the Most High is going to put it in them devils' minds to try to fight. But they're going to find out who the king of terrors is, man. Okay? Mm-hmm. Bin Laden ain't nothing. They're going to find out Bin Laden wasn't nothing. All right, ISIS ain't nothing compared to Yahweh by Shema Shai.
Yeah, that's right.
All
right. Verse 11, the Lord shall threaten, and who shall not be utterly beaten to powder at his presence?
Yep. So, yeah, that's the point, basically, on
mm-hmm.
that. That's
mm-hmm.
the point.
Mm-hmm.
And that speaks for itself, man, you know. That's powerful. That's powerful.
That's zapped, man. Yeah. Hey, like, remember Lot's wife, man? She turned back and turned into a pillar of salt. Ooh. 41.
Yeah.
It's the spirit. The water y'all watching y'all shot. Hey, yeah, but Lot's wife was turned into a pillar of salt, man. You know, and that's exactly what you niggas gonna turn into a pillar of salt. But somebody's gonna break that salt up. Yahweh gonna break that salt up, man.
That's right.
To powder.
Yep. Yeah, it's April 14th too, so that's 4-1-4.
4-1-4-4-4-1.
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
Okay. Alright. So yeah.
Oh, this is Matthew's 13:16. I mean, you can read up if you want to read some more, but I'm just going to get straight to the point. But blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. For verily I say unto you that many prophets and righteous men have desired to see those things which ye see and have not seen them, and to hear those things which ye hear and have not heard them.
That's right. Yep, you got it, bro.
Oh, I mean, because a reason the scripture is being brought up is because we're living in a time that the prophets desired to see, man. They was on Yahweh Shai about when the end of times is going to be, man. When are you going to bring back the kingdom of Yahshua, man? When? And this is when he told them there's going to be wars and rumors of wars, you know? And our eyes are seeing these things right this now, right this day, man.
That's right.
We're actually seeing these rumors of wars, and we're seeing World War III about to get popped off, and we're seeing the mark of the beast, and we're seeing why America is Sodom, Egypt, and Babylon, and all these other various names that America is called, man. Right. We're seeing these prophecies, man. So that's why our eyes are blessed to see these things, and our ears are blessed to hear these things. But you're only going to be blessed if you're tapped into the spirit, man. Mm-hmm. If you're tapped into that Wi-Fi that's connected to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, man, yep. Which is the spirit, man. Yep. And that's the only way that your eyes and your ears are going to be blessed, because you're privy to what's going on.
That's right. Yep. And that's going to be the elect, you know, the electmen of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. And the scriptures say, watch and pray, you know. Mm-hmm. So that's really a commandment, you know. We're supposed to be doing that. So by looking at these... looking out for these different articles, you know, the different things taking place in the earth. That's following the commandments of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Okay, staying watchful, staying prudent. Okay, staying vigilant and mm-hmm. diligent, man. Diligent. Okay, remember that 2017, the year of death, destruction, and yep, mm-hmm. death, destruction, and diligence, man.
Yep.
Okay,
yep.
That's coined by Yahweh Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai ultimately, but. Yeah. The apostles and the elders,
through a mighty vessel that they worked through, which is the apostle elder Tahar, man, yep. the head of Yasharala at this given point in time, man.
That's right. Yep. So yeah, man. With that, you got anything else you want
to say? Hey, man. Continue to watch, man. Continue to pray. Continue to push out these words, man. Because guess what, man? These secrets was given to the prophets, man.
Yeah.
So if you know these secrets, man, don't hide that, man. Yeah. Don't hide that, man. Bring it out, man.
That's right. Yeah, man. Hey, it's getting heated. It's getting heated, man. We're getting closer and closer to the return of Yahweh Shai, man. And righteousness thriving throughout the earth, man. Okay?
That's right.
We're close, brothers. You know, keep on keeping on. You know, keep on pushing.
Yeah, we're living in a time of acts, man.
Yep.
We're living in those times, man. Where brothers waking up and things is popping off, man.
Yep. So, yep, keep the faith, man. And I say that first and foremost to myself, you know.
Okay.
And keep on pushing, man. Hey, we almost going home, you know. So, with that, we're going to say Shalom.
Shalom, Markyam.